Hello, hello. Race night, race night. Here we go again. Hello, hello. Race night, race night. Here we go again. That's a bit of noobish, getting on Twitch ready. Yes, Zolder RCI Split 7 Championship race 5 of 8. And this is, I think, the longest I've ever driven online. It's a 2-hour race with 2 mandatory pit stops, so that's quite a haul. So we're in the final moments of free practice. Just getting my setup straightened out. I don't know what it is about Zolder, I always feel competitive here. It's not that I am the fastest, but I always feel fast here. Fun track, short. With very little room for error. Not going for the fastest time in practice, just looking at some setups and seeing what my fuel use will be, as well. 2 stops in 2 hours means roughly every 40 minutes per stint, so I'm guessing now that I will take 80 liters for every 40 minutes. That should be able to drive it, be able to make a good clean run and have enough fuel for each stint. Just not looking at these times, and I hope to qualify in the top half. If it can be anything inconsistent, then like last week in Barcelona, I have a good chance to make a good pointer. But most of all, hoping for a fun race. Seems to be a full server again, well, full, I think the max is 40, but 22 drivers. It's a nice load for a good race on a short track. So, quick track guide. Now in the back, approaching the last chicane, the Jackie X corner, if I'm not mistaken. Dumps us on the short pit straight. And on the corner called Eerste, which basically means first. Stargazer, de sterrenkijkerbocht. Kanaalbocht. I don't know this name.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
The small chicane. A long sweeper called Butte. These corners have a mixed name, so these 2-3 corners have one name, which I don't recall. And over to the last one here. Oh, forgot to brake a little bit, a little late. and on to the main straight, which of course has the Jackie X chicane to round it all off. Roughly 1.5 minutes per lap. The really good guys tend to get just below that. I tend to be just above it, which is fine for me.
Yellow flag ahead, be careful.
Overdriving, not too. No. Too fast. We don't want no tire screeching. For 2 hours, that's the. I haven't ever driven that long online. Offline, I've done so. And I hope I can make it, because this will be a number in which people get disoriented or tired, especially with the temperatures now in Western Europe at least. It's been around 25, 26 degrees these past couple of days, meaning it's in most computer rooms probably a bit around that temperature as well, at least in mine. So plenty of stuff to drink. And what can one do but his best? Oh. So for the race, I think I'll go for 80, 85 liters, something like that, to make a around 40 minute pit stop. Making two pit stops, at least that's, I think, what's the rule. Two pit stops. I'll just put it over here. Not going an actual pit stop at the moment. So not going for fast lap times, but in any case 132, 133, I think my record here is 131 something. Not my main goal. Let's see how qualifying goes and what the weather is, because this is okay, weather is okay, track is fast, rub it in. But of course, if the rain comes, then well, everything can change, of course. So we're in the wait period before our qualifying session. No one is safe from this track, indeed, because this track has quite a number of high curbstones, which, well, most GT3 cars frown upon. The front engine cars the least, but the mid engine and rear engine cars can have a bit of a bumper here. Same settings, 720, 6721. Let's go qualifying. Here, late breaker, try not to swerve out, because you immediately get in descent, and it slows you down all around along the straight. So slower is better in that one. Flat out, through those curves, coming really good on the line. You can take it flat out in most cars at least. Here we go. Yet. Let's first get a time before we really start to go overdriving, clawing for a position higher. It's kind of rough. As you can see, the S can take it. Ferrari is now holding me up.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Past him. Without issues.
Well,
very nice time.
Yellow flag ahead, be
I don't know why it is, but I always feel fast at Zolder. I think it was the first track that I ever drove at when I got ACC, when it came out. It feels very confined and cozy. It's certainly an older style circuit like Brands Hatch or Donington.
Sector 1.
That's too bad. Let's start up on the other one. Didn't want to hit him. So that time is invalid now. Braking error. There you go again.
Losing time in sector 3.
Bit of late braking, but wouldn't do that much in the race for the tires, scrubbing them. For qualifying, it gave me 3/10 more. That wasn't so good. Lost the tenths over there. And that was just sloppy. Quite a good time, but still puts me in position 22. I find a bit of disturbing this. I think I mentioned it earlier, this is supposed to be an amateur split. So there are 7 simultaneous races on this track, splits, where the top drivers go in 1, and then in 2 and 3, etc, etc. 7 is an amateur split. But when I see people driving 129s, those aren't amateur times, meaning these people are not supposed to be in the split. Not a gripe, just an observation. Yeah, 132. It's about the best I can pull off here. About it, then it's fine. Gives me time to reflect. And take a last minute break. So be right back. And we are back. Okay. 73 seconds now. 128.3, come on. It's literally the fastest time I've ever seen here. And then a huge gap behind that. Yeah, that's weirdness. I would expect something around Mazak. Number 9 of Honda of all cars to be amateur times. But okay. Consistency will be key because, like I said, 2 hours race, that's really tough. So I do expect some issues, some accidents, some spin-outs, maybe pit stops with repairs, which will take a lot of time. So let's just keep our fingers crossed that we will be part of that and make good routing. People already in the pits. So we have number 40 still going, and number 515. 40s in. And here's 5.5. Mandatory pit stops 2. Within pit windows with refueling. No tire changes, but that's of course an idiocy. It does mean they're going to make one pit stop with a tire change and one without. It should be doable. Okay, let's see. 18:21. I'll take the 17:21. Current setup. It's a new tire setup. 85. And the first pit stop. I'll take 80 liters. No, I'll do it differently. I'll do one long pit stop, 100 liters. And the tire set, pit stop 2, also 2 liters, but I keep the tire set 3. No, 4. 4. So I make a 1 hour stint. Let's see if that it's possible, because there's no info on the pit window. But we'll see how it goes. Not too worried that, as I'm not that on the edge driver that I can see times improving with every liter that I burn. Let's do it like this. Pitstop number 2 is basically just a splash, with pitstop number 1 being a full pitstop with tires. Yes. Let's see if that works. Could be interesting to see what strategies work out here. That's of course the issue here with 2 hour race. It's not just about being fast, it's also about being smart. Which makes it fun. This is what GT racing is all about. Double checking. It's quite some time that I've done this. First stint, 100 liters, which should take me around 1 hour. With tire set number 3. On the first pit stop I will add 80 liters and go to pit stop, go to tire set number 4, which is a new tire set. Yeah. And on the second pit stop I will take 80 liters but stay on tire set number 4. So basically I will change tires once around the hour and then do the other just a splash and dash. And probably I don't need 80 liters there. Probably I can go 50 here and 50 here. Let's make it 55. Because in the splash I can add some liters if I need more. Yes, this is it. Don't look back, no guts, no glory. Whoever picked this track for 2 hour race needs shooting. Yeah, I can imagine. This is a daunting track for GT3 cars. And why? I'll tell you why. Because this track has, I said it before, high curbstones, which are very near to the track. And GT3 cars, which have very little lateral downforce, meaning they can't go sideways, they can't skid, they can't drift. Meaning that if you take one too many, you will just bounce around, lose your downforce, and crash out of the corner. That's about it. And the front engine cars can handle them a little bit better. But the mids, worse. And the rears, terrible. Porsches. with the rear engines. Ferraris, Lamborghinis, McLarens, they don't handle curves quite as well. Okay.
Stay in single file.
Single file, full formation lap. Putting some heat in the brakes as well. Tires will warm up pretty soon, but if I put more heat in the brakes first, the wheels, the tires will warm up from the inside, and warmer brakes mean advantage at the start. So we'll see what the pit windows will be. I'm hoping it will be one big window, but of course with two pit stops I don't know how that will play out. It's a bit of a gamble, but if it pays off, then I have one pistol with tires, and then the second pistol is just a splash to get to the end, a splash of fuel. Up. Be watchful, because the Aston Martin isn't the greatest accelerator. Best side to track for this corner, but survival is key in the first corners, and it'll be a long race.
Car on the left.
Okay, so the pit lane is over the whole race. Take it by all means.
Clear on the left.
I don't care. Long race.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Not the cleanest. That means that I can play out my strategy. That means that I have one long window to do my two stops. Meaning I will just burn off my whole tank. Oh. That's not too good. Got a little too close there. Driving. Tires are good. Predictably, I'm in the 132s with a full tank gas. So that's good, that's consistent. Oh boy. I have to be careful, otherwise I'll get penalties. Well, I missed it and did it a bit slower, but it was still too fast.
Well done, mate. You've lost a step so far.
out of the brake just a fraction earlier. So far, so good.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
They didn't look good. Mr. Webb. Behind me has disappeared. Little breathing space. Oh, the shift. Not that easy. No.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Snapping at my heels. Roberts in the 97 Aston Martin.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
But like I said, this is a difficult circuit to overtake. Small, narrow, confined, windy. This is an opportunity for him. We can take it for all I care.
Clear on the left.
Blocking me off. That's putting me in a disadvantage on the next one. That's too bad.
Clear on the left.
stupid. That's an error that it's gonna cost me. Okay. Normally if you hit the sand, then you lose so much speed. Stop overdriving. Take it easy, take it slow. 2 hours is a long time. Daisy. Coming up on some back markers. Now it's letting me through. Falling behind or not, at least I'm keeping in my kites. As well as the guy behind me, of course. Well, nominally, GT racing is close racing by default. That means that the number 20, Mr. Chapman, was qualified quite high. Then an incident in one of the earlier laps. As he's doing quite a pace. Not really closing in on it. Bit more space between me and the guy behind me, Mr. Morrison. Closing slowly on Jacob in front of me. I can build some pressure on him. I can phase him a little. Closer. Okay, 20 minutes on the way, 35 liters burnt. That's of course including formation lap. Just each tires. What really helps here is the mid-corner stability of the Aston. That really makes it a fun and relatively easy car over here to drive. What doesn't help is the relative slow acceleration of the Aston. There are some slow corners here. Most of the corners are slow, and then a fast straight behind it, or a faster bit behind it. Meaning the acceleration hurts. Also do is the next stop is a tire stop anyway. Put again 100 liters of fuel in, and the second stop is just a 1 liter. Really short. That was made by the second pit stop, very short. Instead of splitting 2 times 50 meters. Yeah, we'll adjust. If I didn't do already, I don't remember anymore. Now I set up the second as a splash and dash this stop. No tires. Driving my own race, my pace is good. Try and get closer to J-Cab, but not really doing so. Number 20, Chapman is edging away. So he's definitely faster. Just came to be in the 20th position due to an incident or something. If that's the case, maybe he already also pitted. Yeah, indeed, he has a 1 next to his name. So he already made a pit stop for repairs or something. Maybe new tires, so it could just help him in the end. That's what's so fun about 2-hour races, endurance races, so to speak. Strategies really come into play. Can remind you this week is of course in Formula 1 in Baku, Azerbaijan. But what's also maybe even more interesting is the 24 hours of the Nordschleife Nürburgring, which is an insane race. Starts tomorrow at 4:30 local time, ends Sunday 4:30 local time, and is completely free to watch via stream. So if you have the time, Google it, find the stream, and enjoy, because it's a marvelous race. I see the horse edging in again. Quarto for race done. 1.5 hours to go. Grueling is the word, as it's fairly hot on my attic. It's now raining outside here in the western part of the Netherlands, so the air is warm and heavy with moist, meaning I'm sweating like a pig. That almost happened. Morsing is a bit of a yo-yo now, but I'm losing Jacob. Couples in pits. She must have escaped. There, so that will cost them. That gives you, if you escape and make a shortcut to the pits, then you'll get a freeze on your controls for like 1 minute or something before you can actually start in again. In essence, if you're not really quick, that ends your race. With regards to getting any kind of a ranking that receives points. Missed my break point. Just over half of my tank, 54 fuel used. basics, 25 minutes to go until my planned pit stop. I still feel good. Pressure and temperature is okay. Just on the high limit. Made an error behind me. But now so did I, so. See Campbell still in the pits. If he's ever coming out, then he's firmly at the back now. Someone is already retired. We were 22 drivers, now they're 21. Try to not to do that when stuff has happened to me. Sort of like rage quitting, but. Especially on longer races, you can always get back, you know? And I think the top 16 get points, so. Tiring. Normally this race would, normal online races, sprint races are 1 hour. So in 20 minutes it would be over. There's a whole another hour to come. This is heavy stuff. And Pazur has had his first pit stop. He was qualified first, if I'm not mistaken. Well, at least they're in the higher regions. Driving the Lexus RCF. Very great car to drive. I dislike this because it's all trivial maybe, but due to some licensing issues, I think Kunos is not allowed to allow repainting of the Lexus, so you can't make your own repaint on the Lexus. It's a bit of a bummer. And he made an error. Now you have to come and get me. Almost made a braking error there.
Car on the right. Clear
okay.
On the right.
That's I'm not the only one having concentration issues, it seems. But that's to be expected, like I said. If these drivers are all in this part of the world. If they're not, they're not, but anyway, the 2-hour drive is a long drive, and if it's also warm, concentration takes a dive. We are not professional racers. We are armchair sim pilots in an amateur split as well. Oh, they're number one already. That is fast. Being a lap after 40 minutes. No way that's an amateur split. Sorry, no way. Proietto, he was in first qualification. And he's miles ahead of the number 2 too. 2 also, 2-2. Vagaries to the English language. In any case, he's fast. Eight is as well. Philipsen did a pit stop already, so he's probably a lot faster than me. But in any case, you're now racing me, so I'm not moving aside, no blue flags. Unless I want to avoid a crash, of course, because that doesn't help. because it's a narrow track, it's very easy to drive a defensive line. There's only a couple of corners where if you drive defensive, you'll be actually a lot slower entering the corner. This one's being one of them. And I think the other one is the first corner after straight. Number one in front is also taking a slightly slower pace as he's driving there completely uncontested. He's still faster than me, but not by a long shot driving the times necessary to let me in 40 minutes. Basically, the guys behind me are all faster, but already have done their first pit stop. So I think they're going to do normal pit stops with tires and or fuel, while I'm playing one slower pit stop and one really fast pit stop, so that could give me some nice results. Not saying that I would win this thing. I have 11 minutes to go, I still have 24 liters of fuel. Guys behind me are snapping at my heels. let them. In 10 minutes I will make my pit stop. And they probably know it. So why run the risk of trying to overtake someone that is at the moment just as fast as they are? Get me one of those Formula One drinking bottles with a straw. Remember Kimi Raikkonen, Binotto. No Kimi, you will not have to drink. Well, that's the same feeling I have now. Oh, bad exit. Philipson and Bajour are doing their own fight behind me, so that helps, of course. Fighting takes time. Oh, it can take me. It's a fraction faster than me.
Losing time to the car in front of sector 3. Clear on the left.
I don't mind, because when I take my pit stop, he's gone anyway.
Clear on the right.
Not very stable, buddy. Illusion, my pistol, but if I can make it hard for you, I will. I saw that Lexus going over the curbs. I don't dare do that with the Aston, even if it takes curbs well. Just to me, it poses risk. I've done 84 liters in 55 minutes. My tires still feel okay.
On the left.
Okay, what you're gonna take me. which is fine. But if not, fine too. Go for at least an hour, so I have a split on my tires. I know that these tires last 1 hour, that the next ones will do. Logically speaking. Guy is all over me. I don't want him pressuring me into a mistake. So I'm going in. Fill to 100. Tires at 4. Check. Pistol for myself. Hydrate. Different strategy will throw this lot all over the place now.
Mandatory stop is now clear. Let's go, go, go.
Okay, we have to remember, remove all the fuel but 1 liter. See, there's some guys that have 2 stops already. Basically, I can do my splash anywhere. For any strategic reason, I could do so on the next lap already. But for now, I'll just do it when I get held up, I think, or just as a mid section at the half hour point. Lucky, some people will do a 2x normal stop. That will really help my game, because my second stop will basically be 3 seconds or something instead of 30, 33 with all the bells and whistles in it. But how it will play out, we can only see after the finish flag drops. Here comes the number one again. Still no stop made.
halfway mark, still a long way to go.
Indeed, still an hour to go. Off there. Number 11 is 11 seconds ahead of me. Let's see if I can close in on him. The next two cars in front of me are Lappers. They're gone. I don't care. They're not in my area of contention. Seconds now, so it seems to me that I'm quicker. I should mark that on a single piece of the track, like the straight. In between is a bit finicky. Now it's back to 10 points now. Basically 11. And the leader is in the pits for his first pit stop. Azure, the number 11, has already made two pit stops. Meaning, no matter what I do, I will not catch him. But I still have to make one pit stop, however short it may be. Basically driving the same pace as the number 10. wide. Tires are a bit hot now, so I guess the temperature on the track is going up. Nothing to worry about though. It'll just be a slightly less grippy. Tenth place again. And Jacob is now behind me. Too late. I have to brake a bit earlier over there because it's really on the inner side of the corner. No! What happened there? Why did I lose it? Light damage, okay. Let's see if there's anything wrong with the handling of the car. So far it doesn't seem so. Brake straight. Accelerate straight. Top speed doesn't seem affected. Not that it's that important on this track, but... body car or... Monza, you're screwed without your top speed. That seems fine. Okay, not gonna repair it then. Jacob also has one stop to go, and I think he stopped some round, some laps ago, so he's probably on my same strategy as me, just doing a really quick splash. So I have all intention to keep him behind me. Succeed is the question. He's going for it.
Clear on the right. Car on the left. Clear on the left. Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Ah, cool.
Clear on the left.
He outbraked himself. Just to give me some air. Very late pistol to the guy make. Number 3 in the race came out and he still has one stop to go, so he made his first pit stop after 1 hour and 17 minutes. Still J Long is about 11 seconds away from me. So I hope that his pistol will have, next pistol will be full one. Because then I will take him via pit stop strategy. Wow, this is grueling. Whatever the outcome, I need a shower. Myself slowing down a bit, the critical points, the chicanes. Just to be sure to not make any mistakes, because those chicanes can ruin your whole day. Fly over them, go straight into a wall, get heavy damage. And say goodnight. Still 20 drivers in contention, meaning 2 have dropped off. the number 9 is now. No, the number 8 is now. Someone pitted before me. Who was in front of me? Pazur, but Pazur has had all his pit stops done. So I will never catch him. Don't know what's ahead of him, of course. Team drivers, someone has dropped off again.
Car on the right.
Whoa,
clear on the right.
Spun out.
How's the car coming up behind you?
Just missed me.
Pull behind the car in front in sector 2.
Drive a Honda that fast beyond me. I cannot go fast in a Honda. So if I make my splash around 30-minute mark, I should have roughly 50 liters in the tank, meaning fuel used should not be, well, let's say above 45. Anything of these standings now. Mazak is number 3, is number 2. Okay. If I remember correctly, in the start of the race, he was around my position. So he's done quite well then. He's going for a second stop.
Losing time to the car in front in sector 2.
Was in front of me, we had a crash, I think. Now he's a lap down. and still also has a pit stop to go. If you want to pass me, go ahead, Ralph.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
But you have to work for it. One or two laps, then I'll make my second and final pit stop. Who's blue flagging?
There's a car exiting mid lane. The faster car is approaching. Car on the left. Clear on the left.
That was him. Gooch, the number two ranker. I don't care about Campos, he's a lap down. What is worrying is that Webb is now behind me. Webb has had all of his pit stops. Swain behind him hasn't. I still have no clue what's going on in front of me. This is of course only what I can see. The limited view on the left hand side of the drivers around me. Now I have to make sure that I have 55 liters coming out of the pits. At the half hour mark. Then I'm sure that I won't get fuel issues at the end.
There's a car exiting pit lane.
No, Mazak is ninth again. Are there two Mazaks then? Otherwise, oh, watch it now. Otherwise, I don't understand it. That must be it. There are two different Mazaks. Maybe they're brothers or something. Slower one. This is the moment for me to take a pit stop.
There's a slow car ahead. Yellow flag ahead. Watch out in front.
No. 55. No repairs. 4 seconds. Go. Now for the end sprint. I've bottle arm behind me. Bottle arm still has to pit, so basically behind me is safe. From what I can tell, everybody in front of me has pitted, but of course, I don't know what's up there in the list. I suppose people could also even have double stinted their tires. In essence, you can drive 2 hours on these tires. I've done that sometimes in an offline race. Recently driven the 12 hours of Bathurst in 12 hours. Double stinting sometimes. And that worked, but of course that's not a very windy circuit. Apart from the mountain part, mountain bit. It's all quite straightforward.
There's a car in stupid lane.
Now the number 3 is between us. If something's gonna happen, then I'll be rank 14. Basically my only hope is on the pit stops of the guys in front. But still have to do a lot of changing stuff, adding more fuel or even tires if they have a 30-second stop. Total meaning 45 between driving in and driving out of the pits. Then I might have a chance to overtake some. I must say, I'm quite tired. Squinting, blinking my eyes. I'm feeling rivers of sweat driving down my chest and back. not here. I'm going in free. Six. Of course, it didn't matter if you didn't double stint in the tires because you'd have to refuel somewhere. That takes such amount of time that changing the tires falls into the same category of time. So you won't save anything by not doing it. I smell something, but for some reason I think I can take it. By this point we're all tired. Sloppy. Basically on the same pace. Maybe that backmarker can spoil something for him. It was the Porsche that spun beside me, I think, a couple of laps ago. Oh, I'm 13 again, so someone made a pit stop and fell back. Even behind Swain. Just enough to spoil it.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Now it's on me.
Gaining on the car.
Let's see. Taking this corner wider gives it a better exit. Should try that too. Minutes to go. It's my break points. Bad. Just to try to keep on it. Acceleration, but it does make the corner faster. Break a bit earlier there. The hairpin. Those 4 tenths that I won on the first track, first part. Oh, sliding out. Changing moments. And it's so hard to keep your concentration 2 hours straight. I don't know what his conditions are. It's pouring hot in here. There he comes again.
Car on the left.
That's gutsy. To apologize to him. Did break a little early, but thank you. Yeah, that will cost me. Double yellow ahead. Crash on the left. Back in 10th. Boy, this is intense. Blue flag for what? Minutes ago. Shaking it. Do your best. But I'm not wasting time because Mr. Zlatnik is only 3 seconds behind you. Championship and is back to 12th. He was like 20th at the beginning of the race. So you have to make careful. Ah, hold miss there. So he made a pit stop also. Careful not to hit anybody, because that will mean my 10th place goes down the drain and I'll be back in 12th. There's Mr. Chapman. How's this gonna happen? What's this now? Chaos at the end. 6 minutes to go. Where are all these people coming from?
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
It's been a hard story to keep my 10th place. Oh, they tap each other out. I just see it in my mirror. Or my camera mirror, or whatever it is. Chapman still in contention. Long has overtaken Zlatnik. Okay, focus though. Less than 5 minutes to go. Minutes to go. Less than a second between me and the number 11. But he is quicker than me. Who knows?
Car on the right.
That's stupid.
Clear on the right. Car on the right. Gaining on the car heading sector 3. Clear on the right.
Losing it. Back in 11. Ah, with 2 minutes to go. Zlatnik nowhere in sight. Thank you. Yellow flagging yet. Not somebody in front. Oh, come here. Trying with all my might for that final push. Phillipson is in this, so I'm back at 10. What a race, what a race. Now if only Chapman could crash out. He's edging away from me. Frankly, I'm almost done. I'm pooped. Missed my breakpoint. No, this is it. But 10th. Coming from 17 in a 2-hour race is a great result. Fantastic, what a race. Okay, this was fantastic. Oh, there are some people here that have, well, I don't rank them as amateurs, let me tell you. Let's go to the highlights. Because that's always interesting to look at. Let's see. Restart. Clean away at the start. Fun thing is, it's by driving consistently that gets you there somewhere. No, I haven't won, doesn't matter. Was never in the cards. Ah, that was an healthy one. But you know, if you go from 17th to 10th, then you had a great race. Nothing to it. Like to replace in this sim. Very action minded. That's behind me. Behind me. All the action happened behind me. What a great car to look at, the McLaren. But the Aston is at the moment still my favorite. But if I would get into another car, then it would be a McLaren, I think. Well, these guys really took it out on each other. Trying so hard. Making a mistake is deadly. You lose so much speed. And again. like in real life, these GT car stuff gives such great races. These cars are perfectly made to just battle it out. Still being fast without being overpowered. Like Formula One, Formula cars, they have to drive on rails, otherwise their package won't do. So that's made for trains. GT cars, nope. GT cars can do more freely, but get bitten if they make a mistake. Again behind me. I mean, all the shots without being the subject of hand. Philipson overtaking me. Well, not exactly. Tried. Hier bij Marco Pazur. On the inside. Yeah. Textbook. Follow a bit. Now I make the, yeah, he made the chink, which startled me. Banked up Porsche. Great stuff. But I did tap him in lap 66, Daniel Zlatnik, so I'll apologize to him. I think he braked too early, earlier than he did in previous laps when I was behind him. But he caught me out, but in any case I came from the back, so. Thank you. see Peter Jacob, but I don't see Carl Swain. I see myself. So overtaking Peter Jacob by Carl Swain is... well, not in this shot anyway. Damage on these cars. Only superficial, so by the looks of it. Exactly an overtake. Cool repaint. Drive different lines with these cars, even on a windy track like this. You just can't do that with Formula cars. Very cool. Must be because I'm in the pits or something. Like the other overtake, I'm nowhere inside, so he's overtaking me, but probably because I am in the pits. Otherwise this is Carl Swain overtaken by Toby Lauer, or Toby Lauer overtaken by Carl Swain. I don't know. Anyway, this is a strange overtake. Slotnik and me. In lap 66. Oh yeah, he made an error here. He spun out. And I took him. Took him back though, I think. Because in lap 66 I tapped him. At the second chicane in the woods. Inadvertently. But alas. No replay of that. Okay, I've seen enough. I'm tired. Quick look at the stats. I think safety will have gone up. Well, that's not doing what it should. I'm tired. Anyway, thanks for watching. This was a great race. Next week, I hope to do some driver impressions of other cars, but I'm really busy. So if that works out, probably on Monday. Maybe this weekend, I don't know. Next week, Thursday, final race in the FD Race Department Super Trofeo Cup. And on Friday, RCI Championship race number 6 of 8, Alton Park, 75 minutes. Yes, thanks for watching. See you soon. See ya. Thanks.